Good morning and good evening, ladies and gentlemen. This presentation was presented during the Journal Club Dental Public Health, Harvard School of Dental Medicine. Thank you, Dr. Bruce Donoff and Dr. Stephanie, for the invitation and introduction. Today, I would like to share about preventative dentistry, from research to Starfish Oral Health Movement. There are four sections of presentation which will cover from research to policy, how it sparked into empowered movement, both demand and supply side, how this is relevant to COVID-19 pandemic that we face, and lastly, how we vision the future ahead. Today, allow me to bring you to Indonesia, a country where I serve, consisted of 270 million people. 20% still live under poverty line. The population of Indonesia is like several countries collect all together. The width of Indonesia is like the distance from London to Boston. We have dentists and dental nurses, which each covers more than 10,000 people. Caries disease has been a problem like everywhere else. Based on National Survey 2018, caries prevalence in children of 6 years old was 93%, with average 8 decades per child. Currently, we have no oral health section in Ministry of Health, which means oral health is considered low priority and as a consequence have very limited budget. This graphic is showing DMFT decay missing filling teeth data for 6, 9, 12, 15, 18 years old children per province in Indonesia. Based on that national survey, can be seen that the severity and the speed of caries disease is very different one province to another province. This suggested that one-size-fits-all approach will not overcome the problem. So, back in 2006, my dissertation research was focusing on developing a caries risk self-assessment tools to empower parents and children so they can prevent caries disease by modifying behavior as early as possible. The requirement for this risk assessment where it could assess the multi-combination of caries factors, can measure the microbiome status in quick and cheap way, could give recommendations, but most importantly, should be able to change the behavior of parents and their children. Subject study was 13 kindergarten school with a total of 2,887 children and their parents. In 2008, caries risk simulator Irene Donut is developed. Since then, it is utilized to increase the importance of dentistry in the minds of public and for parents to understand caries process, risk, and management. So, using this Irene Donut software, we just simply fill in the data. Understanding that getting patients to practice better health habit is the greatest challenge, Irene Donut software followed the principle of frames, developed by Rolnick and Miller. It is said that people will not change if we just give them advice. To be able to change the behavior, we need to give them personalized feedback, give them chance to take responsibility. We can give them advice, but let them choose from a menu. Deliver it with empathy and make them assured that they can do it, or we call it self-efficacy. After we answer 15 questions, a donut diagram then will show up and telling us the child probability of having new decay. This is what we call personalized feedback. parents and children can simulate which bad behavior they can manage, and the changes will then show in the new donut diagram. Every time a bad behavior is changed, the risk becomes less, or your donut becomes greener. By doing this, parents take responsibility to choose from a list of advices. After that, parents can print a checklist to enable them monitor the approved action every day. And from this risk assessment, the software will further suggest what behavior changes needed and whether they need a remineralization therapy, surface protection, or even restorative treatment. In doing all the process, it has to be carried out with empathy and giving self-efficacy for the patient. When we socialized Iron Donut software to the field, I realized that many places did not have either computer or laptops, nor internet connection. That is why we developed the paper-based version of Iron Donut software, where the calculation can be done manually. And why is it so important to motivate parents? Because they are the decision maker for the child. In 2017, we realized that almost every mother carries a smartphone. So we developed Iron Donuts apps available in Android and iOS version. These apps can be installed free from Google Play Store or Apple App Store. We then constructed a dental immunization program as a countermeasure of traditional school oral health approach. The dental immunization program is simple. Focus on prevention before it becomes decay. Consists of three pillars. First is risk assessment. Second is remineralization therapy. Third is surface protection. And because all caries and even periodontal disease started from plaque, so it is very important to do a correct plaque control. The strength of overall program is on community empowerment. So risk assessment, remineralization therapy, and plaque control shall be done by the parents and the schools, while the health providers will then focus on surface protection and other curative treatment necessary. After we define dental immunization, then we roll it out to the community. The success indicator that we used were the easiness to transfer the knowledge, whether the program is truly effective in reducing the disease, increasing dentally fit status, increasing caries-free status, acceptance towards program, and last indicators are sustainability, which measured by ownership and willingness to self-finance the activity. All indicators were achieved during the implementation of the program. The first indicator is technology transfer. Initially, to finance the program, we went to many places and need to find any interested stakeholders. Important to note that the first supporter of this program was Ministry of Education, which given us matching grant in three provinces so the program can start rolling. Funding coming from different sources in each area today, for example, from the parents, from dental nurse school, from city mayor, from health district, and finally from Ministry of Health. Measurement of easiness in transfer technology can be seen from these pictures. Accepted technology means enthusiasm, excitement, and joyful new experience. And this picture is showing the children when they played the Iron Donuts in their computers. Mothers also experience a an easy transfer knowledge by learning to detect the earliest sign of caries or white spot in their children. So parents are empowered with new knowledge and responsibility. Children also has been empowered by building up their interest to refine the toothbrushing skills. The usage of three-tone disclosing gels help children to visualize the pathogenic plaque as personalized feedback. Of all the effectiveness indicators, there has been reduction of the bad behavior, for example, the behavior of drinking milk using bottle. In 6 months of implementation of the program, we can observe there is a reduction from 18% to 1% towards drinking milk using bottle. And also within 6 months of the implementation, we can also see the success of the preventive indicators, that is percentage of caries-free children, which increase in 4 schools that we observe. But of all the programs, the most important thing is about sustainability. And sustainability is measured by ownership and willingness to pay. So from this side, you will see pictures telling about ownerships. Like this slide, the parents' pupils' periodic meetings were actively engaged and produced creative ways to solve their problems in implementing dental immunization program. Motivated headmaster consistently promote the parents to implement dental immunization in their daily life. Dental immunization then inspired local school to have a sacred ceremony in surrendering children's bottle milk and replaced by glass. This sacred ceremony is called bottle milk graduation, endorsed by Mrs. Suryati, the creative headmaster. Not only able to remove the bottle, but the schools also transform the used bottles into beautiful educational tools. They also celebrate what they mention as their dental festivals, and these are the creation of their used bottle milk. Ownership also shown by dental health professional, which is excited, although they have to use simple innovative technology, but they don't feel irritated using it. Headmaster become advocates and spread the news to another 90 headmasters. Ownership also shown by willingness of the schools to lead and organize oral health campaign. Currently, all the financing is moved to self-financing. The parents manage themselves to collect $4,000 per month for dental immunization activities. The value of the money is equal to 3x or 3 cigarettes in our country. The last data that we can monitor is there are 500 self-financing schools that are able to make this program sustain. But it is only the tip of the iceberg. As there is one dental nurse which I know that are able to conduct this program in 20 schools, and her name is Atun. She said she has never been so happy that she now works with passion and purpose in life because of this program. So this program, we have seen that it can roll out by itself from autonomy to autopoiesis. According to Sustainable Development Goals, to achieve more sustainable future, partnership is important. Global linkage has providing substantive support in our case. Many countries has invited us and make us share about this program. And Dean Brustunov has been a remarkable and tremendous support. With the help of many people, we are able to publish dental immunization book. This give impact to Ministry of Health Indonesia, producing a national regulation on the implementation of this program nationwide. Of all, the demand creation and the empowerment in the community still needs provider support. To facilitate the process, then every dental health profession form a spider-like network which can connect online, each of them easily from many cities in Indonesia. It is a disruptive innovation, cut down cost, time and distance, but still give high impact. We try to build a new dental professional culture based on respect others, care and share, support one another. In this online community, everyone is a hero. The ultimate goal is not only dental professional can increase their financial and intellectual and communication skills, but also their spiritual journey that would lead them to happiness. All shall be learned with high digital quotient from everyone. So blended learning was done online and offline, strengthening every process. We learned together how to do totality in caring. We realized that educating and caring more for our patients can grow our practices. We learned together how to move responsibility and accountability for oral health onto our patients, so that our services have greater value and aim for empowerment, both the health professionals and the community. This picture showed how in many places health professionals able to empower community to take care of their own health. Parents, teachers, children are excited to be the important part of this movement. We realize it is important that all continuing education were delivered in new way, reserving something beyond expectations every time. At most, provide a collegial environment where learning is shared. And key indicator of success are increased financially because of the increase intellectually, having more clinical set, having more communication skills, more leadership, and of course more patients. But not only increase financially and intellectually. Above all, the most useful asset of a person is not a head full of knowledge, but a heart full of love, with ears open to listen, and hands willing to help. So increase in spiritual quotient. The beauty of the work of Dr. Nurul was her ability to mobilize resources not only from dentists but everyone in the health center to care about oral health. She has demonstrated willingness to work, aim for the best, not business as usual, and willingness to serve others. The other work done by Dr. Anton, who worked in the government health center, which showed give your best and the best will come back to you. This happy patient because the decay has been filled, and this proud dentist because that day he has become a hero for his patient. So we learned that only in giving and serving others we will find happiness for a lifetime, and a happy dental profession will serve their community better. This video was made by a periodontist who was touched by this program and decided to go out from her clinic, reaching out people which she never met before just to share about oral health. In this video, you will see the best way to pursue happiness is actually to help people, because there is nothing else makes you happier. Thank you. conclude that in engaging dental professionals need STAR approach, spider-like network, totality caring, aspire for empowerment, and reserve beyond expectations. And the key indicator of this successful engagement were dental professionals who are empowered financially, intellectually, spiritually for happy life. How will this community empowerment and starfish movement in health providers be relevant to this COVID-19 pandemic situation? Like an umbrella, the activities that were done were meant as protective action. The COVID-19 pandemic actually have worsened the oral health inequalities, so dental care now need to be more responsive to the needs of their populations. Reorientate dental care towards a less invasive and more preventive approach. So COVID-19 is actually an opportunity to reform in dentistry. The latest finding suggests that there is evidence for the role of glycocalyx microbiota interaction as competitive mechanism against COVID-19. A dysbiotic mucosa in the gut will give open receptors for the virus to bind, while healthy microbiome will cover the receptors and make virus unable to enter. How this finding be relevant to oral health? Oral microbiome, as we know, is the second largest and diverse after the gut. The larger and the more diverse microbiome, the healthier we become. A homeostasis or balanced oral microbiome condition has an essential role in body's immune response to infection and in maintaining overall health. That is why in this pandemic, preventative dentistry is getting important more than ever, as healthy oral microbiome might protect you from COVID-19 infection. Recent studies have shown that dysbiosis that happens in the mouth does not stay in the mouth. Instead, pathogens can travel to other systemic organs and create systemic diseases. This is possible mechanism on how disease in the mouth, such as caries, gingivitis, periodontitis, would increase risk for severe COVID-19 symptoms. So again, more than ever, empowering each person towards having healthy mouth is becoming very crucial. It is an easy, cheap, well-accepted approach, but can help reducing the burden of the health system. But it cannot be done alone. Dentists, dental nurses, doctors, other health professionals, midwives, headmasters, teachers, parents, public health workers, leaders in community, policymakers, dental educators, each has very important role and need to work inclusively towards prevent oral systemic problems, as oral health is a gateway to systemic health. Lastly, what would we expect for near future? There is a consortium of university in USA that concentrate in global health, namely CUGH. Its members are 170 institutions, among them are Harvard University, Boston University, UCLA, Stanford, New York University, University of Pennsylvania, and etc. Global Oral Health Interest Group, or we know as GOHIG, is the first and the only one working group inside CUGH that focus on oral health. Under Dr. Brittany from Harvard, GOHIG has able to formulate what is needed in the dental curriculum to produce dentists which are not only as clinicians, but also as leaders, innovators, advocates, learners, can work interprofessional and strong in primary care, which means strong in preventative dentistry. This additional curriculum is named Global Health Starter Kit. So we hope to be able to continue a path that has been created, and as a new director of GOHIC, I have responsibilities of translating Global Health Starter Kit into Starfish Health Movement with engagement of each and everyone here. I humbly invite all of us to hand in hand together and be a hero for someone. I would like to end my presentation by thanking Dean Bruce Jonoff, he is forever Dean in my heart. There are many mentors, leaders, and friends attend today whose names are clearly written in my heart, and they always stay by my side in my difficult times. Thank you for holding my hands and lifting me up so I can keep moving. My journey has been ups and downs, but in my lowest situation, you tell me that don't lose your way. So that's the end of my presentation. Thank you for watching. And if you still have more questions, please email me or WhatsApp me so I can reply back. I hope that from this program, we can find some collaboration with you all. Thank you.